All right, so number six. If we read the directions say, like the first word is draw, right? So you know you're gonna draw something. So you're not looking for a number answer or you're gonna write down words as your answer. The answer is that you drew something, right? So draw a line through each point, okay? Now some of you took both of these points and just drew a line through the two points. You can see, you can understand that confusion, but it doesn't say draw a line through each, like through both points, but through each point, okay? That means each line gets its own point, or each point gets its own line, excuse me. With the given slope, the slope is given just above the graph on the question. It says the slope is 1/4. Okay, and remember the slope is the change in y over the change in x, okay? Change in y over change in x. So change in y over change in x, that means that if I start at one point and I want to find another point on the line, then I change y by 1 and change x by 4. And they're both positive, right? So I'm going to do both of those as positive changes. So if I start here and I do a change of y as a change of y in the, let's see, I don't know how to say it. If I change y by 1, that means I'm going to go up 1. And then if I change x by 4, I'm going to move over 4 in the positive direction. That means to the right. So there we go. There's another point right there. So now you can see why this line looks the way it does. It just starts at this point, or starts, but it has that point on it. That point is on the line. You move up 1 and over 4, up 1 and over 4, and you find another point on the line. If I were to move up 1 and over another 4, I would find another point on this line. If I were to continue this line, you see it would go through that point as well. And so with this point, we're going to have it make it have a slope of 1/4. If I go up 1 and over 4, I wind up being over here off the grid. So we could go instead the other way. We could go down and to the left, and that would make the same line. Because if I started at this point, I went up 1 and to the right 4, I'd get back to that line at that point that we were given. So that's what the directions were saying. It was saying through both of these points, okay, each of them getting their own line, draw a line, so two lines. And those two lines both have a slope of 1/4. Right. And one conclusion, right, they wanted you to look at, what do you notice about the two lines? The two lines are parallel. Okay, so what can we say about parallel lines? What do they have in common?
They're like beside each other going the same direction.
Well, the same direction, they're always going to go up and over the same amount.
They'll never cross.
They'll never cross. Okay, so that's the definition of a parallel line. So how can we be sure that they'll never cross? But they both have the same what? The same slope. You'll notice, I mean, they were setting you up for that. 4, 5, and 6, they were setting you up for exactly that. They made you draw two lines that each had the same slope. And every time, 3 out of 3 times, we saw parallel lines. So we could safely conclude, and we'd be right, that parallel lines have the same slope. And if we go the other way, if you have two lines that have the same slope, you can be sure that they're parallel. All right. So that's number six. And hopefully that confuses, that clears up that confusion some of you had about what am I supposed to do here? Am I supposed to draw a line through there and find the slope between the two points? No, you're supposed to have the slope be 1/4, in this case, 1/4 for both of these points. Both of these points have a line going through the half circle. Okay. Next, number 18. Give us these two points, -3, 6, and 2, 6. First, we'll just find the slope as we learned we could find the slope last class. And then we'll look at the line and we'll see So remember, we learned that we're going to find the change in y, right? These are two y values. So we're going to find the difference in those two y values. I'm going to find the difference in the two x values. Right? Here are our two x values. And see what the slope is. Well, from one point to another point, how much does y change versus how much does x change? When we go to figure out how much y changes, right, we came up with the idea of subtracting the two y values. We take 6 minus 6. What do we get?
Zero.
So we get a zero in there. Let's look at the denominator. Not that it's going to make a lot of difference. I did 6 minus 6, so I need to do 2 minus negative 3. Then we subtract the negative. What is that?
Positive.
Yeah, it's positive, so it would be
2 plus 3.
Positive 5.
Positive 5. Now, what is 0 divided by 5?
Zero.
Okay, and remember what division means. It means we're going to take this thing and divide it into this many pieces. Even though it's a little silly, it still makes sense. If I have five things, here are five things, or sorry, zero things. Okay, well, let's not put that. I'll use that in just a second. If you have zero things, right? Here on my hand, I have zero things. Zero of anything that you like, cookies or dollars or quarters or whatever they are, right? There's zero of them. Let's say $0, okay? And the five of us are gonna divide these $0 up, okay? You take yours. You have yours, Aubrey, yours, Robert.
Take
it. And I have mine. How much do we all have?
Zero.
Makes sense. Now,
zero.
Now if we look at it the other way, okay, so zero, the answer is zero. It has a slope of zero. Let's think about 5/0, because some of you are still struggling with, like, well, I just got it flipped over. Is that okay? No.
No.
It's very much not the same thing. So 5 divided by 0 is this like impossible thing to do. I have five things, okay, that exist. There's five things. They're tangible. I can touch them, right? And I want to do something with them. I'm gonna split them up among my friends, okay? Not including myself, okay? The thing is, though, I have zero friends. So here are all the friends that are going to share of these five little white tokens. I try to give them to them, but they're not there. They can't hold anything. They can't possess anything. They can't have these things. So I can't say that that person, who doesn't exist, has five things. I can't say they have zero things, because they're not a person. They can't have any things. Okay? So we run into all sorts of problems, right? I try to say that they have five, and that doesn't work that they have five, because they're not a person. It doesn't work that they don't have, that they have zero, because there's five things. How could that be turned into zero by just dividing them up among some people? So there's just no way to talk about it. However I try to reason through it, I come up with problems. So if I divide by zero, I try to divide things among zero people, there's no way for me to define that. Okay, it literally means there's no definition for dividing by zero. If I looked in the math dictionary under divide by zero, there would be nothing there. No definition. Can't define it. It's like a word doesn't exist. Okay. So, that's just kind of a side note. Because the slope of our line is zero. And like I said, I wanted us to look at this line and see how that makes sense. If it has a slope of zero. There is a point at negative 3, 6. Negative 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 6. So this line goes just flat across. Right? And something about this line is like something's not changing at all. Right? What's not changing on this line?
Alright, like whatever's going
on.
The y.
Okay, the y value isn't changing. Stuff is going into it.
Yeah,
like going. Oh, okay. So like, if this is the graph of filling up a glass with water. There's no water going into the glass. It's just not changing.
Coming out.
Going in, coming out. It's just sitting there on the counter, not even evaporating. Like, not any change is happening to the amount of water in this glass. Okay, it's frozen. Although frozen water does turn into gas without turning the liquid first.
Yeah. But that's not part of math.
That's true. We don't need to worry about that.
That's fine.
So that's what we would say, there's zero change. Like there, it's just over time, as time passes, there's just no change. Zero change, zero slope. Okay? Now an undefined slope would be a straight up and down line, which would be crazy. It would be, like that has there's no way to even have that make sense if it's a glass of water. Right? If there were a straight up and down line, this has an undefined slope. If this line is straight up and down, it would mean that it has all levels of water, right? It has 3 inches of water, it has 6 inches of water, it has 7 inches of water, it has -5 inches of water. Okay? It has all those levels of water all at the exact same time. Which is impossible. Right? Could it be all the way full as a glass could possibly be, and also have negative values of how high it is, and also be 1 millimeter high? Like, it can't have all of those values all at once. That can't be the height of the water in the glass. All at, you know, say 3 seconds. It just can't be. Can't be that. Right? And even as I'm talking, some of you are looking at me like, and you should, because what we're trying to do is define an undefined slope. It's undefinable. It makes no sense. Okay? So this would be a slope of something like 5/0. So I'm trying to answer the question. I got 5/0, is that okay? Well, no, it's not the same as 0/5. And if the slope is 3/4, oh, is it okay that I got 4/3? No, it's very much different. Okay, so when we flip a slope over, it's very much not the same thing.
Not the same.
And in 24, all right, it gives us a table. -8, -2, -1, -4, -6, and the next one is 10, -13. And it says, to find the slope of the line, all these points, it says, in the directions, it says, all these points are on a line. It says to find the slope. And what we're trying to learn here is, that basically, to get straight to the point, I can choose any two of these points. Any two. Combine any two points. Find the slope between those two points. It'll be the same. Right?
Yeah.
If all of us, you know, is it possible to choose from? Yeah, it's possible. We have enough people in here that we could conceivably have all chosen different combinations of two points, and we would all get the same slope. Okay, because that ratio is always the same. So if I choose these two points, this one and this one, and you choose two other points, we'll both get the same slope. We'll both get the same slope. And I'll draw the line in just a minute, and you'll see why that is. Okay. But if I want to calculate the slope, I can just subtract the y values. Remember, we subtracted the y values yesterday, right, over the difference in the x values. So let's say -6 - 1. Okay, what if I then do -2 - 4? Is that right?
No.
What did I get wrong there?
You have to line up.
Right, because 4 and -6 come from this point, and so they should line up when I'm finding the slope.
Yeah.
So 4 minus -2. -6 - 1 is -7. 4 minus -2, that's +2. 4
six.
Plus 2 is 6. All right, -7, 6 is the slope of this line. Right. Just to prove that I know what I'm talking about. If we choose these two points instead, let's do these two points maybe in a different color, red. Okay, I'll choose these two points, and I'll find the slope between these two points. It'll be the same.
You do 8 and 1 and 4 and 2.
8 and 1 and 4 and 2.
10. 4 and 10.
No, you can't. I mean, you can't combine. You'd be using like parts of information from all four points, right? We just need to find the slope between two points. And if I'm going to find the slope between two points, I'm not going to use 4 points, right? So I just need to find 2 points and only 2 points to find the slope between those two. What's going to happen here is we're going to find bigger numbers, like between these two points, which are far away from each other. There's going to be a big change in y and a big change in x, right? And then that slope's going to simplify down, to the slope here.
Yeah.
Alright, so finding the difference between these two y values, we'll go negative 13 minus 8 over, well, I use the negative 13 first, so I gotta use the 10 first, 10 minus negative 8. Negative 13 minus 8, what's negative 13 minus 8?
Negative 5? No. Negative 21.
Remember, this number is already negative. Negative 13 is already pretty negative. And then we're gonna subtract, which means go left on the number line, right? We're gonna go even more into the negatives. Negative 21 over 10 minus negative 8, that's 10 plus 8.
18.
Well, these both have a factor of 3 we can factor out. Factor out of 3 from there, we get negative 7. Divide this by 3, we get 6. We get negative 7, 6, right? That's the thing about the slope. It's a ratio between the change in y over the change in x. Whether we look at a little section of the line or a big section of the line, that change in y over x is going to be the same. How do I know it's negative 13 first and not 8 first?
Yeah.
It doesn't matter. It won't make any difference as long as JC said before, as long as these line up.
But right. Y always goes on top.
Y always goes on top.
But X always goes first.
Don't try and put these two things together. You're going to confuse yourself. It doesn't have anything to do with which goes first when you write it in a coordinate and which goes on top or bottom when we're calculating the slope. They have nothing to do with each other. So don't get confused that X goes first here in the coordinates, but that y goes in the numerator of the fraction. It's totally different. Okay? Try and separate those two things in your mind. They both have to do with lines and stuff, but they're not related. Alright? So the change in y always in the numerator, and the change in x is always in the denominator. And when you think about it, there's no first and second in a fraction. There's just the numerator and the denominator. Okay. But I can do negative 13 minus 8 and 10 minus negative 8. I can do 8 minus negative 13 over negative 8 minus 10. It won't make any difference. We'll get the exact same thing. The only thing that happened there is where I got negative 21 over positive 18, and flip them around and get 21 over negative 18. That's the same number. The negative divided by positive is negative, positive divided by negative. They would both simplify down to negative 7, 6. So let's look at these points on the line. And see why we're going to get the exact same slope, no matter what you choose to do. Just take this. Alright, so I'm going to graph all these points. You're going to see they're all going to be, I can put 4 points on here and they could just be kind of crazy and random and not be a straight line. But these ones will be, and it says so in the directions, so it shouldn't be a surprise if they're on the same line. Negative 8, 8. There's negative 8, and there is 8. So there's a point right there. Negative 2, 1. Be careful, I still see some of you graphing points and getting X's and Y's backwards. Okay, be careful about that. Aubrey? Take some good notes?
Yeah.
Nope. 4, negative 6, and 10, negative 13. Now that's going to be kind of hard to see, but I think you can try it. 10, negative 10, 11, 12, 13. See all those four points there?
Yeah.
So whether I look at the slope between these two points, or these two points, these two points, these two points, these two points, any combination of two points, we're going to get the same slope. Because the slope is just a ratio. It's just a fraction. The change in y over change in x. If I choose two points that are far away from each other, I'm going to get these big numbers, big change in x, big change in y. But they're just going to simplify down to the simplest version of the slope, whatever that might be. Okay. And that's true for all of these. This is going to have a change in x of 12 and a change of negative 14 for the y. And that was simplified down to negative 7 over 6. Okay? Any good choices and bad choices, Sarah and Aubrey?
Yeah.
Not acting like we remember that. All right. So, if we have 2 points, you can always find the slope between them by the difference in y over the difference in x. Always the difference in y is in the numerator, difference in x is in the denominator.
Yeah.
Okay? Any questions?
No.
Okay, let's take a quick look. I gave you this little review already at the end of class. What kind of slope is this?
It's positive slope.
It's a positive slope. Okay, so if you were to look at a graph of the 2 points and they went up like this, then you know that when you find the slope, slope should be positive. That's at least one little check you can give yourself. And this slope is?
Negative.
And this slope is?
Equal.
The y's are equal, and so the y's not changing, and so the slope is zero. There's zero change. This slope is?
Undefined.
Because really, it's like all change, but all in 0 seconds. This all happens. All this change happens in 0 seconds,
already
which is
there.
Impossible.
How would that work?
It wouldn't. That's why it's undefined.
It just
okay.
wouldn't work.
It just wouldn't work.
No matter what you did.
No matter what.
What if you were inside it and like made it work?
It would certainly
change the world.
Either very rich and famous and win the Nobel Prize, or you could also be very, very evil and do terrible, terrible things.
Like what?
That
wasn't
even
possible. Like what though? Like what kind of terrible things?
You've just made possible the impossible, so who knows what's happening.
We're
starting
this new
Albert
on
the chat. Alright, let's put everything away, please, except for a piece of paper, a pencil, and a calculator. You don't need a calculator. Okay, so we have these 2 points, and we find the slope between the two. If you have tried everything that you can to take this and just make this like a number crunching exercise where I put the numbers in the right place in the formula and get the right number, you're setting yourself up to get a lot of wrong answers, okay? Because you're going to forget. So let's just, again, remember what this all means, right? So there are these 2 points. They're on a graph. There's one at 2, 2. You don't have to draw this to figure this out, of course. I don't want to just let you think this is just a number crunching exercise. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 4. So there's another point right here. And these 2 points are on a line. Here's the line.
I missed that
one.
Yeah,
I did this right.
I thought the 4 was
I do everything
up,
wrong.
Like negative.
I thought it was 7.
No, I thought the 7 was up top. You know.
Yeah,
line.
I thought
yeah,
so. That's
what
I thought.
I didn't.
Like,
zero
the 7 was a Y instead of a X.
Yeah, it's okay. Same.
Okay. So, like I said, be careful about that. Don't switch up your X's and Y's. And the slope is just how much of a change in Y do we see between the 2 points, and how much of a change in X do we see between the 2 points. We don't need to count them off. We can calculate them, right? This one is at 4, and this one is at 2. If I want to find the change between the two, I can say 4 minus 2. If I want to find the change between these two from here to there, rather than counting over however much it is, this one's at 7, this one's at 2. 7 minus 2 tells us the change in x.
I didn't start 2.
4 minus 2 is 2, and 7 minus 2 is 5?
Yeah. Okay, sorry. So the graph, I did 7 and then 4 over, but I still got the right answer.
What?
She did.
Like, I used y. I did 7 on y and then 4 is x. And I still got it right.
Well, then you must have made 2 mistakes to get the right answer with the wrong.
Well, like, I did this part first, and then I did that to make sure it was, like, positive.
So you did 4 minus 2 over 7 minus 2.
Yeah, and then I graphed it to make sure it was positive.
Uh-huh.
But I didn't do that.
Oh, okay.
But it was still positive.
I see.
So
you found the right slope, but you graphed it wrong. But the graph had a positive slope, so you're like,
yeah.
So the slope is 2/5. That just means that between any two points, the ratio of vertical change to horizontal change is 2/5. Right? And if we were to go to a point out here, then I would have a change of 4. There would be 4, which means that would have to be 10. Right? Vertical changes twice as much, so horizontal changes twice as much. It's still a ratio of 2/5. A change of 2 for the y, a change of 5 for the x. The ratio stays the same. All right.
So what found what?
Point something out to you. So putting together like what Kaden asked and what JC explained earlier, it doesn't matter what order we put these in, okay? Whether I do 4 - 2 in the numerator or 2 - 4 in the numerator, it doesn't matter. As long as we can line up the points, okay? So if I do 4 - 2, then the denominator should look like 7 - 2 because 7, 4 is this point, and 2, 2 is this point. If I flip it around and I do 2 - 4, then in the denominator I should see 2 - 7 because 2, 2 is this point, and 7, 4 is this point. Okay, so as long as we keep those lined up, we should be good. Okay. So to put that in like a formula kind of a feeling, if I let's say I call this point number 2, and this point number 1. Right? This one's the first one, it's on the left, okay, so call point 1, call the other one point 2. So this is an x value, and this is a y value. This is an x value, this is a y value. This is the x value from point 1, so we call it x1. Zach?
Yes.
Why don't you scoot a seat back? No.
Okay.
Get
up.
Scoot a seat back. Okay, so this is the x from point 1, so we call it x1. This is the y from point 1, so we call it y1. And Zach, why don't you get a piece of paper and start taking notes on this stuff? Point number 2, this is the x from point 2, so x2. This is the y from point 2, so y2. So my formula could look like this. As long as the right x's and y's line up, just like I've outlined here. I can make my formula like this, y2 - y1, right? We're going to find the difference in the two y values, over, this would be x2 - x1. My formula could also look like y1 - y2, as long as the denominator looks like x1 - x2, doesn't matter. But this is what you're going to see in, I would guess, 99% of textbooks and classes where you might learn about slope in the future. If you ask a math teacher what's the formula for the slope, most of them are going to say exactly this, y2 - y1/x2 - x1.
Isn't that really fast?
I've just had it a lot of times.
I know, but you said we're not supposed to use formulas.
No. I just don't want you to think that it's only about formulas. Formulas are useful in math. Not surprising, math is probably the number one producer of formulas. Right? But if we make all of math about formulas and memorizing formulas, then we make math really, really a lot harder than it needs to be. Okay. If I just told you that from the very beginning, it would be we give an emphasis on the formulas and memorizing those formulas and using the formulas correctly. But what I want to focus on is just what is the slope? It's a change in the y value divided by the change in the x value. It's just the ratio of the change in y over the change in x.
Yeah.
Now, hopefully we've concentrated on what the slope is, what it means, right, and that it's a rate of change. then you can throw a formula out there and say, well, this, you know, this covers all situations. If I have 2 points, number one and number two, and it doesn't really matter which one I call one or two, then I can write this formula up, y2 minus y1 or minus 2 minus x1. This formula just is saying what, like, Caden and JC's statements and questions from earlier were saying. It doesn't really matter which order we subtract them as long as they line up, and this formula just is making sure they line up. That's all. Now, from here, I'm going to do some graphing just with equations that look different than we have before. We graphed the equations like this. Let's say, okay. One. So we had that equation. I'll once again tell you the long way and then the short way. The long way and the short way. The long way would be, here we go, the long way. What is a graph made of?
Points.
Points. How many points? As many as you want. So since there's no end to them, what's that word we give that?
Infinite
number of points. Where do those points come from?
The numbers.
Plots.
The plots?
No, never mind. That made us
equation. Okay, from the equation. Every point has coordinates, an x and a y coordinate. Right?
Right.
I'm running short on time, so I'm going to have you review this. I'm going to give you some problems to practice on.